ISUPK.
ISUPK, out of 125th Street, Harlem, New York. We are not affiliated with any Muslim group, with any Christian group, with any Egyptologist, with any kind of religious group that you have in your mind. We are out here to represent we people, which are the Black, the Hispanics, and the Native Indians. Under Commanding General Yohana. Now every time we come out, we come to educate with people and to break down strongholds that we know that would be in your mind from the time of slavery. Because from the time of slavery, when we was indoctrinated by the white man, it have a lot of junk that in we had. So we come to wash out a lot of this junk with the truth, the truth of the Bible, the truth of history, the truth of archaeology, to teach you what you've been missing, so that you will know how to walk perfect in the sight of the Lord. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to let you Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians know that you are different people from these heathens that walking around here. You are separate people from these heathens that are walking around here. And when we're talking about heathen, we're talking about all the nations that are outside of the Black, Hispanic, and Native Indians. They are heathens according to the Bible. People that do not serve God and only study in money. Give me the definition of heathen from the King James Version Bible Dictionary.
The definition of heathen from the King James Version Dictionary: a pagan, a Gentile, one who worships idols, or is unacquainted with the true God in the scriptures. The word seems to be comprehend all nations except the Jews or Israelites as heathen nations were strangers to the true religion and all addicted to idolatry.
Right. So based on the description there, they let you know who the heathen are. Black man, if you're following Islam, Islam is a religion from the Arabs. They are heathens.
Right.
That is why they just carry in Mecca to worship a stone.
Right.
They are heathens. If you're following the white man religion, which is the Roman Catholic Church, they will have you worshiping a wood and a stone.
Right.
You understand? That stone image upon that wooden cross is an idol. They are heathens. And also when they make you bow to the standing stone, which is the image of Mary, you understand? That is also an idol.
Right.
So we're going to go in a little bit in the history and educate our people today.
Leviticus 26 and 1.
So everything that I just said there could be backed up in the word of God. God is going to describe to you what these idols and them look like. So that the people can understand, you understand what is an idol. It was one scripture in the Bible where God tell you make any image to him. Whether it's a picture, whether it's a stone, whether it's wood, he don't want you to bow down to anything. He never give you instructions to bow down to anything. Don't bow down to no Hail Mary. He never gave that instruction. But today I'm going to teach you who tell you bow down to that Hail Mary. Go ahead.
The book of Leviticus chapter 26 and verse 1. You shall make you no idols, no graven images, neither the rear you up of standing images, neither shall you set up any images of stone in your land to bow down unto it, for I am the Lord your God.
Right. Tell it, don't set up no standing image of stone in your land, like in Mecca. Where they just take some of we black people to say we're going on and worship a stone. Foolishness.
We're going to go in and show people what we're talking about. Because the heathen will encourage you into all manner of foolishness. All manner of nonsense.
When we're talking about worshiping a stone, this is what we're talking about. They will carry in Mecca to worship a stone. They could come closer. That is no problem, brother. And see what is going on. In the Catholic Church, this is what they're talking about. When are you bowing down to the standing stone of Mary?
Right.
They will encourage you in that foolishness, that
right.
Garbage.
Right.
The Lord just said here in Leviticus 26 and 1, do not bow down to any standing stone.
Right.
Whether it's in Mecca, whether it's in Rome, with the Roman Catholics, do not bow down to any standing image of stone.
Right.
The Lord God of Israel requires no idol to serve him. Right? So the next thing we're going to read today is how you learn these religions. So you might ask yourself, how I end up today in the year 2000 worshiping a stone in Mecca and worshiping a stone in the Roman Catholic Church?
Right.
Where did we learn these religions from?
Right.
When we was in slavery, we was not Christian.
Right.
We wasn't Islam.
Right.
You understand? These things was taught to we by our oppressors.
Right.
So we're going to get a little bit of the history here to educate the people. So we're going to give the people the knowledge so when you go back home, you can be more informed. So we're going to teach you now where these religions and them come from.
Right.
And in connection with us in slavery. Go ahead. Right.
The history of African slaves and their descendants' introduction into religious belief based on European white religious concept is recent. In parallel, the history of the English European colonizing America, starting with the British colonial period in the North America, 1615 and 1776, Africans were confiscated from their homeland and brought to the Americas, were gradually indoctrinated into the Christians.
Pause again, read over that again, in case the people are wrong miss it. From indoctrinated, read over that part.
America was gradually indoctrinated into the Christian beliefs of their white slave masters.
Right, pause right there. So the history line, you know? That we was indoctrinated into the religion and we white slave masters.
Right.
We didn't come with that to strip we our religion, we history, we culture, and teach we their religion.
Right.
That is why the God look like them. When you look at a white image, it look like them.
Right.
Because their religion.
Right.
So it's time now. We don't have no chains on our feet right now, no shackles on our foot, that we come out of these false religions.
Right.
That's encouraging we to bow down to a statue, a standing image of stone, Holy Mother of God. Foolishness. It's time we wake up from these foolish religions.
Right.
And we're going to bring all the history out today. And where does Holy Mary come from? Go ahead.
Africans brought to America came acquainted with the European religious beliefs before they began practicing the American evangelistic faith. They are here today, Methodist, Baptist, and Holiness.
Right? So again, one thing this piece of history are missing,
that are going to give my people today. They told us that we is Africans.
Good.
But the truth about that, when you go back into history and you dig back into history, when the state of Jerusalem in 70 AD was destroyed, a million Jews fled into Africa because we skin color the same as the Africans.
Right.
But when we became more industrious than them, they team up with the Arabs and sold us into slavery to the white man. That is the Africans and the Arabs. So they just call we African, but we really Israelites. We're a different nation of people.
Right.
Just like the Japanese and the Chinese look the same, but they're not the same. They are two different nations. And you could get us history I'm talking about in a book they call Babylon to Timbuktu. Also the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. Because the Lord say, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Right.
And then it have a common saying that I say, if you want to hide anything from a black man, put it in a book. Because black people don't like to read. They like Netflix and cable and internet, and they don't like to read. So you're out here to educate with people. So we could stop following false religions in these last days. Go ahead.
According to the Catholic tradition, the rosary was instituted by the Blessed Virgin Mary herself in the 13th century.
Right.
She said, after appeared to Saint Dominic, giving him a rosary and asked that the Christian pray the Hail Mary, our Father, and glory be prayers instead of the Psalms.
Right. So, it have a man in the Catholic Church named Saint Dominic who said Mary appeared to him and tell him, give you a rosary and read the Hail Mary.
Right.
What foolishness is that?
Right.
You understand? You just have a dream and say, pray with a rosary. Don't say Psalms no more. Pray with a rosary and pray, and the whole world, let's pick it up and let's go with that. Everybody doing it, nobody do the research. And they're just following it.
Right.
Like sheep's going over a cliff to slaughter.
Right.
This is the age of information. Use the internet for the right things, not the wrong things. And educate yourself. Get books and educate yourself. And don't be following garbage in the Roman Catholic Church and garbage in the Islam mosque and all these foolish religions. Come back to your God. The God of the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians.
So you're going to
bring out what the scriptures say about following dreams.
Right.
You just get a dream and you're following it. You understand? Go ahead.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 34 and verse 1. The hope of a man void of understanding are vain and false, and dreams lift up fools.
And dreams lift up who?
Fools.
Go ahead.
Verse 2. Whoso regardeth dreams is like him that catcheth at a shadow of following after the wind.
Go ahead, don't go
forward. Verse 3. The visions of dream is resemblance of one thing to another, even as the likeness of to a face. Verse 4. And of unclean things, what cannot be cleansed? And from that thing which is false, what truth can come?
Right. From that thing that is false, what truth can come? You understand? Some white man dream you must pray with a rosary. You understand what truth will come out of that?
Right.
He not even the nation of Israel.
Right.
When you're going into history, they are from the nation of Edom. They are completely different nation. So how we can tell you, you understand? Mary come to him and tell you, pray with a rosary. Like foolishness.
Right.
We people have to stop following this foolishness.
Right.
Before you follow stuff, research it. God has follow stuff. We poor parents deny internet. They might not have access to much books, so they could not research. But you research things before you follow it.
Good.
Go just follow stuff. And you're not researching it. By madness. The Bible, by the Catholic Church, part of the books of the Bible, the Apocrypha from the Bible was taken out.
Good.
By the Catholic Church.
Good.
You understand? So for you to get the whole Bible, You have to get the 1611 King James Version Bible.
Right.
You can get it online.
Right.
Right before the Catholic Church took out part of the Bible.
Right.
You understand? These are things you people have to know. And they took it out so they could push the Christianity. So these are the things that we have to understand. Our people might not know. Right, so it's important that we educate with people and let we people know the truth in these last days. Than they just following lies and fables. The how we following these lies and fables because they know it's God, chosen people. And the day we wake up and come back to the law, statutes and commandments, he says he's going to come back in Deuteronomy 30 and set all on the earth.
Right.
And take all the curses out of it and win this lower state. And put me back into rulership. And put the other nations into servitude. So they don't want you to know that. Because they want you to remain their servants and your children and your children's children remain their servants.
Right.
Go ahead.
The book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 16. And what agreement at the temple of God with idols?
Read that again.
The book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 16. And what agreement at the temple of God with idols?
What agreement at the temple of God with idols? All these religions, they encourage you in worshiping idols. Who following Christmas, when you bow down to pick up a gift under the Christmas tree,
right.
You're bowing down to Nimrod.
Right.
They're tricking you to worship it. Nimrod.
Right.
What fellowship a God with idols? He's the God of everything. He don't need to make a stone for you to bow down to it.
Right.
Go ahead.
For you are the temple of the living God. As for God hath said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people.
What?
Verse 17, wherefore come out from among them and be you separate, saying the Lord.
Read that again.
2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 17, wherefore come out from among them and be you separate, saying the Lord.
Come out from among them idol worshippers and be you separate. Because you cannot find God in the Catholic Church,
right.
Bowing down to Hail Mary.
Right.
You cannot find God in Islam, bowing down to a stone in Mecca.
Right.
You cannot find God in the Hindu temple, bowing down to Hanuman and Kali.
Right.
That way, all that nonsense advertisement on TV telling you come to the Pundit go help you. The Pundit can't even help himself. If he can help himself, he will cure all the corona cases in India.
Right.
But he coming to tell you, he go help you. He go help you take your money. That way he go help you do. And this next topic is an important topic. This is how our nation remains strong. You ever see a Syrian man breeding with different races? They don't do that. They breed within their own.
Right.
They keep the money within
right.
their nation.
Right.
They're not giving the money to your nation.
Right.
They're not doing that. Yeah, man. They're not doing that.
The book of 1 Ezra, chapter 8 and verse 93. Let us make an oath to the Lord
right. That
we will make and put away all wives which we have taken of the heathens with their children.
Right? So, the things aforetime were written for our learning. Before parents understood that here was going on. For we to walk after righteousness, we must let go of the heathen and them. We can't be joined to them. Because when we join to them, we just start to have sympathy for the cause. And we can't come together and serve the Lord. And it has encouraged me like they encouraged King Solomon in worshiping their idol gods.
Right.
So we must separate from the heathen. Take out the heathen from out of your bed. Take out the heathen from out of your bed.
Right.
And love your people. And stick with your people. And breed your people.
Right.
And build your race strong. Just the other day we went through a piece of history with the West Indian cricketers. All them black men and them in the West Indies team. They get money. They get fame. They put themselves with these East Indian women. But the East Indians in the West Indies team, when they married the own East Indian woman.
Right,
that's right.
So when the wealth come out, it going back to their same nation, right, while we giving away we wealth.
Right.
Because them East Indian women and them, when you bring one inside your house, they bring in the mother, they bring in their brother in your business to suck you dry.
Right.
A East Indian wouldn't be with you if they do something to gain.
Right.
They're not going with no broke Negro. They're going with a Negro that got sucked dry.
Right.
And fatten the bones of the family.
Right.
By the mind state.
Right.
So now the last thing I want to teach you before I go is something from the greatest king that ever lived in Israel, King David. He going to let you know the purpose of the heathen.
Right.
Now we stop keeping the laws of the Most High. That is why we are under these curses now and we are under the heathen. But when we come back as a people to keep the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High, which you can get a proper interpretation of the Bible in the ISUBK, as how for us to come back together as a nation, we are going to rule this earth again. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Now King David is going to explain to you what is the purpose of the heathen, right? So we forefather, King David, going to let you know the purpose of the other people, because you might ask, but what about the Chinese man? What about the white man? What about the East Indian? What is their purpose on the earth? King David going to let you know. Go ahead.
Psalms chapter 18 and verse 42. Then did I beat them small as the dust before the wind.
Right, go ahead.
I did cast them out as the dirt in the streets.
Right. Cast them out like the dirt in the streets. You understand? Like a house cleaning. Go ahead.
Verse 43. Thus has I delivered me from the striving of the people, and thou hast made me the head of the heathens.
He make us who?
The head of the heathens.
Go ahead.
A people whom I have not known shall serve me.
What is the purpose?
I have not known shall serve me.
To serve me. Go ahead.
Verse 44. As soon as they have of me, they shall obey me. The stranger shall submit themselves unto me.
Right. Go ahead.
Verse 45. The stranger shall fade away and be afraid out of the dark close places.
Go ahead.
Verse 46, the Lord liveth and bless me, my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted.
Go ahead.
Verse 47, it is the God that adventured me and subdued the people under me.
Good.
In a perfect world, black man, Hispanic man, and Native Indian man, if you was given God laws, all these heathens and them would have been servants and handmaids
of
the nation of Israel.
That's right!
That is who, that is the purpose. But because we sin against the God, we are not leading them. But I want for we to get back on top again.
Right.
And let them do the work.
Right.
Let them do the work.
Right.
Instead of oppressing me, do the work. Instead of coming on TV and boring cockroach and pests, do your work.
Right.
And serve me.
Right.
And serve my nation.
Right.
And with that, we say shalom.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's already turned from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord?